People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, you would have been seeing the videos on some of the things that happened in Spanish Town over the last 10 or 15 years. And you would have heard the gruesome acts, right? Of course, you know, there's the Charmaine Ratchery and her daughter Crystal, of course. You'd have even the things that happened to other clansmen, like, for example, Scott Thomas, right? Man, them take off him head, put it in a bucket and all them things. I know them can't find it to this day. And you might be wondering, well, at least we're now past those days. At least now them things they not really happen again. That's not true. That is not true. They don't happen as often. But trust me, things are gone. And things not even make the news. I'm going to give you the perfect example. Is it the suitcase that's up on your screen right now? The one in the thumbnail? Listen, that suitcase was actually from an incident that happened last month with a youth who he was a part of the clan system, but you know, as usual, them fall out, right? Split Guan, right? It was a youth by the name of Rusty. Now, back in the day, Rusty was a youth in the system, right? You don't know, end up on wanted man list. Rusty wanted from about 2000. The first time Rusty name end up on the wanted list was 2012. And we're now in 2020. So that sure you say, sometimes they manage up on some list to the point that they even get forgotten because people don't even know if they're dead or alive. Right? But Rusty was a youth who, to be honest, he was quite feared, right? The youth would do him thing, right? No, for the other man, them in our clans, did fear him. And Tesha did have a bag of problems. And then, you know, you're nothing about him. Next thing we know, all of a sudden, a couple weeks ago, start get beer pitcher. Beer pitcher come in. And I'm thinking, what go on? People from the area send me pictures and tell me, say, listen, this just happened. But then I'm wondering to myself, okay, who this? Because when we get the picture of them, it was just a picture of the body in the water, right? And the suitcase. Then I get to find out, say, the person, the individual, is the same Rusty. And the man them go in upon him, right? Take him out of the yard, right? Beat him, butter bruise him. Mash up in teeth them out of him mouth, right? The man then throw hot water upon him, boiling hot water, right? Because again, this youth is a part of the system and them fall out. They don't know, they may take them things too lightly, right? Then pour boiling hot water upon him, burn off him skin, broke up the youth, stuff him in a suitcase. Listen to this part now. That's not enough, you know. Them stuff the youth in the suitcase. Like say, him have some kind of, like him have clothes or shoes or something. And then him carry him down the river Cobre, go dump him. This is 2020, this is recent, this is last month. We're not talking about 2011, no 2012. We're not talking about Nevada Hodges days, we're not talking about James Hines, we're talking about now. And you would think something like this would be all over the news, would be all over the mainstream news, but no. Get lost in the pile. Get lost in the pile. Right, and I guess immediately, I guess them couldn't even identify him or nothing, right? But people, as usual, you have to understand. When you hear say a man who used to roll with the clans, a man who you seen at the system go like this, you have to know, so the only way they can get to him is through him friends them. A man who know him have to go pull off something like this. Because think about how much things have to go right for you catch a youth like this in a situation where he can't even get to squeeze off a couple rounds. One, you have to first know exactly where him live, not just the area, you can't just say lake spin, right? You have to know exactly where him there. Then you have to know exactly which yard him in. Then you have to know, say, alright, him gone in bed, or this happened to him, or him having gun point. You need all those information, right? And not all of the people in my dear own you, I got the information there, right? You can't just set off on a wandering voyage and hope, say, you run into Rusty, say, you go do something like this. No. Them know exactly when they did. Them know send in a position where he couldn't defend himself, right? And them take him out, right? And of course, as me say, them couldn't just take him life and call it a day. Them they have to mash him up and put him through all kind of misery. This is usual clan style. Usual clan style, and you still end up in the real Cobre. People, I don't know who believe this. This is my opinion, right? Of course, I haven't done any scientific research on this. But in my opinion, the real Cobre have the most dopey in a Jamaica. The amount of bodies where the real Cobre will end up in the real Cobre, whether through 87s dash them in there, right, or accident, Or, as a matter of fact, even if you go back to Bakra days, the amount of slaves will lose them life in a real Kobe John Nungle, right? And just in July, there was a story about the two young youth, them, right? The two brothers who lose them life, 17-year-old Cashian Ferguson and 15-year-old Rashian, right? They're my two brothers, two of them drowned same day. But at least that was an accident, right, with the two brothers them. But some people might remember an infamous case surrounding a 7-year-old, right, a little girl by the name of Khadisha Cousins, right? Them find this little girl in the same rear Kobe. She left to go school, right, in November of 2014, right, and then last place people see her was at the bus stop, and next thing they know, nobody can find her. And a couple of days later, she washed up on the shores of the rear Kobe, and at least her family got some kind of closure, where they can at least give the little princess a burial. But a lot of people never get the chance to have any kind of closure for them relatives, right? Because remember, the rear Kobe leads straight out to the Caribbean Sea, right? And the clansman them know that, right? Or any man they go over, they go to see them throw them body. What they hope for is that the remains just go straight out to sea and never ever found again. But obviously the nature of a running water, right, is that nobody is going to stay in the exact center and just keep going down the exact center, right? So people always end up, well, a lot of times people end up on the banks and they end up get found, for example, in a rusty case or the little girl case, right? What I'm saying, people, you cannot, if you were to try and sit down and even draft up some numbers, I don't think even clansman, even the Spanish stone man name, could I give you an accurate figure as to how many Jamaicans have been completely lost in the rear Kobe. Right, it's just one of them places where even the banks are the rear Kobe, right? Whole heap of people get buried along the banks, right? And then the water come and wash it away, and then the actual body get taken down the river. So sometimes when them find a body in the rear Kobe, it's not even a recent incident. Sometimes when them find them, they're so badly decomposed that you can tell, say, a long time the people them dead, remains dead. Right, bones, all kind of thing get washed up in the rear Kobe. It's a place where you might down there and you don't know what might turn upside of you. You don't know what might get washed by side of you. Like Spanish stone people, sand catching people can tell you about the rear Kobe. Right, a lot of haunted. Like back in the day, they used to say that on Good Friday, all the ghosts of the slaves in the drowned at the rear Kobe used to turn up. That used to be a saying back in the day. Or should I say folklore, right? Just like you know what they used to say, a flat bridge, certain times they used to see one table come up. Who remember them stories about tables coming up and, you know, all the Spanish man, them, the Europeans, them, who Jonah try to take up gold from on a flat bridge side and all them things that in a certain time of day you used to see it come up. Right, you know, it's very strange how, I know I'm kind of I'm diverting now, but it's kind of strange how all those stories that Jamaicans used to hear, and at least I know I used to hear, right, when I was growing up. It's kind of funny how the youths nowadays never really hear about them story like one time. But I remember growing up and hear about Flatbridge. I mean, there was a time when if you even go country and you go up on a trip and you have to go drive past Flatbridge, everybody in the bus gets silent, right? Maybe older people remember them days, right? As I said, maybe see them things that go on now. But I remember when I was young and we had got a country, when the bus I get to Flatbridge, all talking stop. All the music turned on. Everybody is just expecting something terrible to happen when you go over Flatbridge, right? And a whole heap of people go over Flatbridge and end up in the same rear Kobe. And by the way, people, just a little fun fact, the rear Kobe, the Kobe mean copper. Right? The reason I'm putting that out there is because I remember when I was young and I hear all these, I guess you could say, dopey stories about rear Kobe. Me did hear say the Kobe mean cobra, as in the snake, right? And that's one of the reasons why the real Kobe was so deadly, because the river was named after a cobra. And you don't know the cobra deadly already. But that's not the case. I think, you don't know, way back in them time there, people wouldn't have any real grasp of the Spanish language. So then they just hear cobra and go, oh, that sound close to cobra. Right? We don't know them thing they got already. Obviously, people never have Google back in those days. Right? And even the same folklore and myths and legends, one of the biggest one I can remember is the reptile known as the Galawas. How many people remember hearing about the Galawas? Old time Jamaican people just say if a Galawas bite you, you need to get to water before the Galawas. And if the girl was get to the water before you, then you are go dead. And if you get to the water before him, it are go dead. Those stories were terrifying as a youth. Only if you grow up and find out that the girl was isn't even venomous at all. But because them look like a snake, them come from the lizard family, but them have a snake looking body. Jamaica actually had a type known as the Jamaican giant galawas, right? I think the scientific name is Celestus oculus, right? But right now them can't find them. They theorize that it's actually extinct, right? Some people are saying they might be one or two, but nobody has seen them. I think the last time them see one was 1840. And people, if you ever Google the Jamaica giant galawas, you will understand why old time people are so afraid of it. It looked like something straight from out of a sci-fi movie, right? Now, speaking about Google, if you want to see the pictures of Rusty in a real cobra and your stomach is strong enough, you can see them on politicswatch.com. But again, only if your stomach is strong enough. In my morning time, most people hear this and people are drinking them breakfast and everything, right? So only if you can manage it. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life, bless.